Welcome to Positive Atheism English channel. Today, I am going to read out the article on The Atheistic Solution by Gora, a pioneer in positive atheism. The Atheistic Solution. Inequality is the problem of modern civilization. Obviously, inequality among people in economic facility, social respect, or in political power is unfair when all men belong to the same kind. There is not that natural difference between man and man as between a lion and a lamb. Yet the difference between lords and laborers, between Brahmins and Paryas, between masters and servants seems wider than the difference between lions and lambs. Also, the variations in taste and talent are not correlated to the economic, social, and political inequalities. Not all white men and Brahmins are intelligent, nor untouchables and colored people are dull. Ambedkar and Luther King falsified the claims of superiority based upon caste or color. Even the difference in sex does not correspond to difference in the ability to achieve distinction. Joan of Arc, Jhansi Lakshmibai, and Madame Curie attained heights of excellence and exhibited powers which staggered men in positions of power and opportunity. Thus, the variations are equally spread out among all people, and humanness consists in the sympathetic adjustment of the differences through love and education rather than in the exaggeration of the differences. If equality among people is fair and proper, how have these wide inequalities come about? Theism responsible. The theistic outlook is responsible for the prevalence of the inequalities. Theistic belief suppressed human initiative and free effort with the postulate that man is not free, but that his life is conditioned by divine will, fate's decree, economic relations, material circumstances, historical necessity, or by evolutionary process. Whatever may be the conditioning factor, the chief character of theistic belief is that man is not free to mold his life. By and large, theism stands for determinism. Theistic belief, therefore, surrenders man's life to God, government, or circumstances, and thereby renders it a matter of drift rather than one of active effort and purposive achievement. The more honest these are, the more indolent they become due to the tendency to surrender to something deemed superior to them. The dishonest, on the other hand, loudly profess faith in God and government, but they have their own secret ways of active greed for power, wealth, and position. So, in the theistic order of life, the honest lie downtrodden due to the surrender of the initiative, while the dishonest achieve economic and political advantages through underhand but active methods. The dishonest rule, while the honest are no more useful in theistic civilization than as laborers in farms and factories, as mercenary soldiers in war, and as voters in democracy. Atheistic rebellion. The inequalities are unfair indeed, but the honest thieves submit to what they consider inevitable and suffer poverty, slavery, and indignity with the silent solace of belief in divine justice, heavenly bliss, and ultimate values. But the pains of the flesh here and now are often too severe to be alloyed by hopes of the afterlife bliss. Therefore, the downtrodden have either to adopt the surreptitious methods of the dishonest and share advantages with them, or they have to honestly rebel against the theistic beliefs and release themselves into free activity and achievement of comforts of everyday life. Those who set free themselves in this manner and helped others also to feel free were regarded as heretics, if not altogether, as atheist by contemporary conservatives. The heretics of the past are the prophets of the present generations. Buddha, Jesus, Muhammad, Marx, and Gandhi are outstanding examples of the prophet heretics. In the wake of their teachings, not only more men become more afraid, but the inequalities were reduced through honest work and love of neighbors. So, atheistic awakening is the honest solution for the removal of inequalities. When people feel free and free themselves from belief in the supremacy of God, government, or circumstances, all people live equal to, because all men belong to the same kind. All cats move equal and all larks fly equal. So all men also should live equal, unless some men dupe themselves into the belief that they are not free, lose initiative and lie low. The death of the theistic faith is the way to revive initiative and to establish equality. Vigorous propaganda of atheism brings about the change. Equality with freedom. In the teeth of opposition by monarchists and accomplices, democracy achieved political equality through the principle of one man, one vote. It was fondly hoped that the political equality, It was fondly hoped that the political equality would lead to economic and social equalities too. It was possible also. If the people exercised their democratic right and compelled their representatives in governmental authority to legislate in favor of economic and social equality, inequalities would have been removed soon after democratic regimes were formed. But that did not happen because people remained in theistic faith. In spite of their voting franchise, they continued to think that their lives were ordained by God or were caused by circumstances. Unless people feel free and know that their inequalities can be reduced by governmental legislation and that they can pressurize the government to enact suitable laws and to implement them effectively, vote is empty and democracy is a shame. Theism defeats democracy. Therefore, a fearless propaganda of atheism in order to awaken the masses to a sense of self-confidence is necessary for the success of democracy. Political equality of democracy will not lead to economic and social equalities without atheistic awareness among the people.
For more videos, please subscribe to this channel, Positive Atheism, and activate the bell icon.